ask. He had this big smile on his face. And after the service, I wanted to see him, so I came by and he said, "Guess what, Brother King?" I said, "Well, why don't you tell me?" He said, "I'm free." I said, tell me how it worked. He said, "Well, I did what you said." But it wasn't just what I said, it's what the Lord said.
All right now.
He said, "I did it." He said, "And I felt dumb." He said, "Because I was buying cigarettes and I'd look around and nobody's there." I said, "Thank you, Lord, I'm free." He said, "I'd open them up and I'd pull one out and I'd light it up and I'd say, thank you, Lord, for setting me free. I'm free. I'm free." He said, when I took the pack out of my pocket, laid it on the nightstand, I'd say, "Thank you, Lord, for setting me free. I'm free from tobacco. I'm free from nicotine. I'm free." He said, "I did it for, I think he said 3.5 weeks or something." He said, "Every day and every night." He said, "After a while, I was doing it almost without thinking." And he said, "I was on a street corner and I went to light up and I said, thank you, Lord, I'm free." And he said, "It hit me. Something went off inside me." He said, "I put it out." He said, "I don't even want them anymore." He said, I'm totally free. He said, "I don't even want it anymore. I'm really free, Brother Keith. I'm really free." And so just a few days ago, this young man comes up to me. He said, you remember that testimony that you gave, Brother Keith, about the young man who wanted to quit smoking and cutting, and you told him to say, I'm free?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "I've been in the throes of addiction, cocaine and heroin and crack," he said, "for years." He said, "I heard that, and I've been saying that for some time." He said, "I'm free." He said, "Guess what, Brother Keith?
Set me free. I'm free. I'm free. Free.
it is not right for the child of God to grieve over the death of someone and be incapacitated with it week after week and month after month. Yep. That's not okay.
Yep.
That's not right. The sorrow of the world works death. There's death in it. Never say, I couldn't live without him. I just don't think I could go on. That's acting like that's they have a bigger place in your life than God does. And if you will, you can get completely free from grief right now. But if you hold on to it like a nasty security blanket, it'll stay with you and it'll get worse. Or you could say,
what?
I'm free.
I'm free. Not gonna be, not need to be, not wanna be. You could say,
I'm free. Cause the Lord has set me free. I'm free.
I'm free.
Free indeed.
Free from grief.
Free
from heaviness.
The Lord has set me free.
Free from sorrow. Christian churches. We're all just broken people.
Oh my.
You didn't find that in the Bible.
Nope.
You mean damaged? That's acting like God can't heal. He heals the broken heart.
Yes.
Does he or not?
Yes, he does.
He heals the broken heart. So you don't have to stay
broken.
Do not let the past, maybe you couldn't even control what happened to you, but you can control reliving it a thousand times afterward. Said out loud, leave me.
Leave me.
Guilt from the past.
Guilt from the past.
Regrets from the past.
Regrets from the past.
Condemnation.
Condemnation.
Sorrow.
Sorrow.
From mistakes.
From mistakes.
Hurts.
Hurts.
From the past.
From the past.
I turn loose of them.
I turn loose.
I don't want them.
I don't want them.
Leave me.
Leave.
Lord, set me free. I'm free.
just stop saying, I need to get delivered.
Yeah.
You must stop it.
Yeah.
And agree with God.
Yeah. Yeah.
That I have been. Delivered.
Yes.
The Spirit of God's doing things.
Yes.
Here's something else he's doing. There's a number of individuals have been restricted by disappointment. Had thought certain things would happen and it didn't happen. Had thought you'd be at a certain place by now in this or that, and you hadn't got even halfway there. Y'all are too quiet. Somebody said disappointment. That's not God. You can tell where it's from by how it affects you. Does it discourage you? Does it make you want to do more? Or does it make you want to give up and quit? Well, let's see if that's from the enemy. Do you have to live with disappointments? Do you have to be limited and restricted and discouraged with disappointments? No! 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 I'm free. The Lord has set me free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
Oh.
if they held their peace, the rocks would cry out. Why? Because it was time to praise God.
Thank you.
can tell that you're yielding to the Spirit of God. You quit thinking about all the problems. Your stomach stops being tied up in knots. And you quit being so tense and you get that goofy growl off your face. And you begin to smile and relax. Because you're free. Because the Son has set you free. I'm telling you, you're free. Unquestionably free. Whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Set me free. I'm free.
Yeah.
down with discouragement, you don't accept any of it because you have been delivered and you are free. Hallelujah. Well, I think that's it.